Aptos High School is dealing with the suicides of two students. The school is now taking steps not only to help students cope, but also teach them about warning signs. Action News reporter Phil Gomez has more tonight, live from Santa Cruz.
That's right, Dan. Aptos High School administrators doing all they can to focus on school wellness by providing a number of services to help all those impacted by the tragic suicides of two high school students. Looks like any typical campus, but what's happened in the last few months has forced administrators, faculty, and students into incorporating suicide prevention and intervention tools. Within the last 3 months, Aptos High School has dealt with two tragic suicides. And the school is reaching out to everyone impacted.
It was definitely something that was a wake-up call, that the simplest things we can pass by sometimes as human beings, and especially here at high school when there's so much going on.
School principal Casey O'Brien has brought in different agencies to provide guidance during this difficult time.
I know our faculty are extremely caring, and they've opened lines of communication, reminded students about what support systems are in place to help them.
Experts say warning signs include major changes in mood or behavior, talking or hinting about suicide or death, feeling hopeless or worthless.
And it may not be that they're wanting to actually end their lives. They often are wanting to end the pain that they're feeling or whatever it is they're going through. And for young people, they may not have yet developed the coping skills to deal with a serious life crisis.
According to the experts, suicide is actually the third leading cause of deaths for teenagers, behind accident and homicide. But having the tools to recognize and support to deal with it will make a difference.
Every student and every parent know that every student is important to us. We're a community that cares.
O'Brien plans to hold a community discussion on campus next Tuesday at 6:30 p.m. in the Performing Arts Center. It's open to the public. Dan.
All right. Thank you very much. Appreciate it, Phil.